yo, I'm easy to national as I speak, you know. Who you think it was, Father Christmas? Well, before me give you daddy in this fuss.
Jamaican singer Millie Small has died at the age of 73 after suffering a stroke. The star was most famous for her hit single My Boy Lollipop, which reached number 2 in both the US and the UK in 1964. It remains one of the biggest selling ska songs of all time, with more than 7 million sales. Island Records founder Chris Blackwell announced her death and remembered her as a sweet person. Really special. It was Blackwell who brought Small to London in 1963 and produced her version of My Boy Lollipop. Millicent Small in Clarendon, South Jamaica, she was one of 7 brothers and 5 sisters, raised on the sugar plantation where her father was an overseer. At the age of 12, she won a talent contest at the Palladium Theatre in Montego Bay, and by her teens, she was recording for Sir Coxone Dodd's Studio One label in Kingston. There, she teamed up with reggae singer Roy Panton, and they became one of the island's most prolific duos, scoring a major hit with Wheel Meat.
No matter where you run and hide, I know we'll meet, yes we'll meet. I know your love for me is strong, dear. That's why we'll meet, yes we'll meet. You can give me all I own.
Blackwell took an interest in the singer after releasing some of those records in the UK on his fledgling record label, Island, and brought her to London in 1963. Small was enrolled at the Italia Conti Stage School for speech training and dancing lessons, and she toured the UK before cutting My Boy Lollipop with a group of London session musicians. Small claimed Rod Stewart played the harmonica solo, but he has denied being present at the recording. Released in February 1964, it made her an international star and helped popularize ska music around the world. It is the ska equivalent of Elvis' Heartbreak Hotel or the Sex Pistols' God Save the Queen, the disc that popularized a sound previously considered to be on the margins of mainstream consciousness, wrote music historian Lawrence Kane Honeysett in Record Collector magazine. However, Small was unable to replicate the success of My Boy Lollipop, scoring only one further hit, a soundalike called Sweet William, later the same year. She continued to tour and record, and appeared frequently on 1960s pop shows like Jukebox Jury and Ready Steady Go. My life seemed very normal to me, even though I was only 17, I took fame in its stride, she told The Express in 2016. After leaving Ireland in 1970, she recorded for legendary reggae label Trojan Records, where her first single was a cover of Nick Drake's Mayfair.
Mayfair strange in the morning light. Mayfair strange on a summer night. Mayfair strangest in the afternoon. Mayfair stretching far above, full of fame but back in love. Could it be we see the Mayfair moon? In the day or in the dark, there's no need to worry or even lie. Mayfair face is clean and nice, but beauty here is cold as ice. Could it be we see the Mayfair sun?
However, it was the B-side that attracted greater attention. Called Enoch Power, it was a defiant response to Enoch Powell's inflammatory, anti-immigration, Rivers of Blood speech that captured the mood of the UK's Caribbean population. Soon after that single, and the accompanying album Time Will Tell, Small stepped away from music, saying, it was the end of the dream and it felt like the right time. In later years, she lived in Singapore and New Zealand before returning to London, where she concentrated on writing, painting and raising her daughter. When My Boy Lollipop was re-released in 1987 to mark Island Records' 25th anniversary, the singer gave a rare interview to Thames TV, where she revealed she had, at one point, been penniless and sleeping rough in London.
That's all experience. It was great. I didn't worry because I knew what I was doing. I chose it. And it was very interesting. I see all the other half live for choice. It's not that I was feeling sorry for myself. It's something I chose to do. Then I can say, bye Lollipop, and then I can come back with my own new version of myself and my world.
Mayfair strange in the morning light, Mayfair strange on a summer night, Mayfair strangest in the afternoon. Mayfair stretching far above, full of fame but lacking love. Could it be we see the Mayfair moon? Mayfair strains across the park, in the day or in the dark. There's no need to walk or even run. Mayfair faces clean, but beauty here is cold as ice. Could it be we see the Mayfair sun?
However, it was the B-side that attracted greater attention. Called Enoch Power, it was a defiant response to Enoch Powell's inflammatory, anti-immigration, Rivers of Blood speech that captured the mood of the UK's Caribbean population. Soon after that single, and the accompanying album Time Will Tell, Small stepped away from music, saying, it was the end of the dream and it felt like the right time. In later years, she lived in Singapore and New Zealand before returning to London, where she concentrated on writing, painting and raising her daughter. When My Boy Lollipop was re-released in 1987 to mark Island Records' 25th anniversary, the singer gave a rare interview to Thames TV, where she revealed she had, at one point, been penniless and sleeping rough in London. However, she took the hard times in good grace, explaining, that's all experience. In 2011, Jamaica's Governor-General made Small a Commander in the Order of Distinction for her contribution to the Jamaican music industry.